In today's video, I will explain muscle anatomy for yoga pose. Today's pose is Warrior 3. Warrior 3. To be honest, this is not accurate Warrior 3 pose. Original Warrior 3 is you raise shoulder like this way. So this pose is like modified version of Warrior 3. But this person is still activating main muscles for Warrior 3. I want to explain three important parts. First part is hip and pelvis. Second part, foot. And third part is upper body. Let's get started from pelvis and hip. I want to focus on two muscle groups today. First muscle group is this one. You see, there are three muscles in this group. This is hamstrings. Hamstrings. I want to talk about main function of hamstring. When this muscle contracts, that brings hip joint to extension. Hip extension is like you kick your leg backward. See, this leg goes backward. That means hip extension. Okay. Next muscle is which you don't see in this picture. So let me explain on this real person. Next muscle, gluteus maximus, that is butt muscle. Main function of this muscle is also hip extension. You kick leg like this way. This movement is very important. So hip extension is for hip movement. These two guys also can move pelvis. What kind of movement? That is posterior tilt. Posterior tilt, what is it? So posterior tilt is that you bring pelvis this way. You kind of twist pelvis kind of backward. This is posterior tilt. Hamstrings and gluteus maximus can do posterior tilt. So this is two main functions of hamstrings and gluteus maximus. Let's focus on this leg, which is weight-sustaining leg. So I want to focus on this leg first. Where is hamstrings? Hamstrings is here. But important thing is, let's focus on her pelvic position. What is her pelvis doing? Her pelvis is on this position. This is anterior tilt. Tendency is, when you bend your upper body, pelvis tends to go to anterior tilt. What's main function for hamstrings and gluteus maximus? That is posterior tilt. That means this side hamstrings is stretched out. However, hamstrings need to contract to maintain this position. One reason is this is single leg stance, right? Single leg pose. That means this leg has to sustain whole body weight, right? So hamstrings need to keep this position, plus this guy needs to maintain balance. That is why hamstrings takes a lot of stress. Hamstring is stretched out, but still this guy needs to contract. This condition is very hard. This condition puts a lot of mechanical force. This kind of contraction is called eccentric contraction. Eccentric contraction. Thus, flexibility and strength of hamstrings is important for Warrior 3. This is my opinion. This side, gluteus maximus, doesn't have to work a lot compared to hamstrings. Of course, gluteus maximus works, but hamstrings takes a lot of stress compared to gluteus maximus. How about this side? This is right side. What is right side leg doing? What is right side hamstrings and gluteus maximus are doing? They are doing hip extension. These guys maintain nice hip extension position. Gluteus maximus and hamstrings are constantly working to maintain nice horizontal position. So, on this leg, these hamstrings are kind of sustaining balance and holding this position. Leg upside, this side gluteus maximus and hamstrings are maintaining leg horizontal position. Okay, this is very important. Let's go to foot muscles. Okay, what kind of muscles are there? There are numerous muscles around foot. I want to focus on this side. There are a bunch of muscles. So I say these muscles are intrinsic muscles of foot. Intrinsic muscles, that is kind of a local muscle of foot. They are so important to maintain foot arch and foot balance. Why is this so important? Because architecture of foot is originally arch kind of shape. This arch shape kind of spread the mechanical force of body weight and athletic movement. So when this arch is collapsed, we can't stand straight up. Plus, movement of big toe and other toes are important to sustain this arch and foot balance. Does it make sense? And there are other kind of muscles other than intrinsic muscles, such as flexor hallucis longus. Flexor hallucis longus, tibialis posterior. And other numerous muscles. Muscles which locate on backside of foot are important to maintain foot arch and foot mechanics. Plus, function of this side foot is freaking important. Why? Because this is single leg standing position, right? Single leg means it's even unstable. Human is biped creature, right? The most of mammals are quadrupeds. Quadrupeds means they have four legs. Human is biped, two legs. Then we kind of lose one leg in this position. Now that is even more unstable. Thus, good coordination of foot muscles is so important. Plus, good contraction, good control of hamstrings is also important. If hamstring is too tight, that pulls pelvis this way, and tendency is that pulls pelvis up. Then your pelvis looks like unstable, uneven. That is tendency. Anyhow, foot muscles, foot intrinsic muscles, and hamstrings are important to maintain this leg balance. Let's go to back muscle and shoulder girdle muscles. To maintain this nice horizontal position, your back muscles need to contract. What kind of muscles are there? Also, there are numerous muscles. One muscle group is erector spinae. Erector spinae that erects spines. So, good contraction of erector spinae maintains nice horizontal posture. Then, anything else? Let's say multifidus. Multifidus is deep to erector spinae. This muscle is also important to maintain spine posture. Thus, nice horizontal posture requires good contraction of multifidus. Anything else for shoulder girdle? I'd like to pick up two muscles. First one is, it's about here, around this area. That is rhomboid. Rhomboid attaches to scapula and spines. It is important to maintain scapular position and spine position. One more muscle, which you don't see, is like this big muscle. This is trapezius. Trapezius attaches to occiput, spines, and scapula. So it's like rhomboid. Trapezius is important to maintain scapular position and spine position. Look at this person. To maintain this nice horizontal position, back muscles and shoulder girdle muscles need to contract properly. Then, to maintain this nice straight line, don't forget, gluteus maximus and hamstrings need to work as well. So basically, this side body, this side posterior part of muscles need to maintain nice straight lines like hamstrings, gluteus maximus, back muscles, and shoulder girdle muscles. And on this side leg, weight-bearing leg, hamstrings and foot muscles need to contract to maintain this nice posture. So imagine it's like T as alphabet. Body weight sustaining leg, posterior part needs to contract. For upper part, also posterior body muscle needs to work. So I think this is nice visualization. Both posterior body muscles need to work. So if you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment and subscribe. See you next video.